Isang mapayapang hapon, Pilipinas! Ito po ang inyong balerina ng bayan, si Lisa Macuja, na bumabati sa lahat ng nakikinig sa DZRH at sa lahat ng nanonood sa RHTV, lalong-lalo na sa ating mga kasamahang alagad ng sining at kultura sa buong bansa. 2 taon na ang nakalipas mula nang umugong ang kontrobersyal na listahan ng mga bagong national artists na naaprubahan ng dating Pangulong Gloria Macapagal Arroyo. Dahil sa maingay at malawakang paghadlang sa nominasyon ng 4 sa 7 pangalan dito, hindi natuloy ang conferment ng lahat sa kanila at hanggang ngayon ay nakabitin pa rin ang isyung ito dahil sa status quo order ng Korte Suprema. Dahil dito, nadamay din ang ilan sa mga itinuturing na karapat-dapat sa karangalang ito. At isa na nga rito ang premyadong pintor na si Federico Aguilar, Alcuaz. Magkagayon man, sa hapong ito, alalahanin natin ang kanyang mga mahalagang naiambag sa mundo ng sining bisual. Samahan ninyo kaming balikan ang pamana ng tanyag na pintor at iskultor na si Federico Aguilar Alcuaz.
Isinilang noong ika-6 ng Hunyo 1932 sa Santa Cruz, Maynila, si Federico Aguilar Alcuaz ay pang-6 sa 11 anak ni Mariano Aguilar at Encarnacion Alcuaz. Nagtapos siya ng secondary education sa San Beda High School noong 1949. Pagkatapos ay magkasabay na kumuha ng 2 kurso, Associate of Arts mula sa San Beda College sa gabi at pagpipinta mula sa UP School of Fine Arts sa umaga. Kabilang sa mga naging propesor niya sa UP ay ang mga pambansang alagad ng sining na sina Fernando Amorsolo at Guillermo Tolentino. Nang matapos sa 2 kursong ito, nagpatuloy siya ng abogasiya sa Ateneo de Manila University kung saan tumanggap siya ng diploma in law noong 1955. Subalit hindi nito pinagpatuloy ang pagiging abogado. Bagkus ay tumulak siya papuntang Espanya para mag-aral sa Academia de las Bellas Artes de San Fernando at maging isang full-time artist. Mabilis nakilala ang talento ni Aguilar Alcuaz sa ibayong dagat. Sunod-sunod na premyo ang kanyang nakuha mula sa mga prestigyosong kompetisyon tulad ng Premio Moncada, Pre Francisco Goya, Pintura San Paul del Mar at ang Premuo Vancel. Umaris siya ng tagumpay sa iba pang dako ng Europa kung saan binigyan siya ng mga titulong Diploma of Honor mula sa International Exhibition of Art Libre noong 1961 at ang Decoration of Arts, Letters and Sciences of Order of French Genius ng 1964. Sa Pilipinas, tumanggap siya ng Republic Cultural Heritage Award noong 1965, Distinguished Service Award noong 1985, Centennial Award for Arts and Culture noong 1995 at Presidential Medal of Merit noong 2007. Makikita ang mga obra ni Aguilar Alcuaz sa mahigit na 20 mahahalagang museo at cultural institutions sa iba't ibang dako ng mundo. Sa loob ng halos 60 taon bilang aktibong pintor, nakapag-exhibit na siya sa mga kilalang galleries sa palibot ng Asia, Europa at Estados Unidos. Noong 2007, ginulat ni Aguilar Alcuaz ang mundo ng sining ng 2 sa kanyang mga obra ang naipagbili sa record prices sa magkakahiwalay na auction houses sa Hong Kong at Singapore. Noong 2009, kasama si Aguilar Alcuaz sa 7 pinangalanang national artist ng dating Pangulong Gloria Arroyo. Subalit dahil sa matinding kontrobersiyang kinasangkutan ng 4 sa mga nominado, ibinaba ng Korte Suprema ang isang temporary status quo order na pumigil sa pagbibigay ng karangalan sa lahat ng nominado maging sa 3 itinuturing na karapat-dapat. Sumakabilang buhay siya noong 2 ng Pebrero 2011 sa edad na 78. Pagamat hindi nabigyan ng state honors dahil sa nabimbing National Artist Award, pinarangalan siya ng mga kapwa alagad ng sining sa isang malaking tribute sa Cultural Center of the Philippines. Sumasaludo ang Art2art sa premyadong pintor at dakilang alagad ng sining na si Federico Aguilar Alcuaz.
Sama po natin para bigyang parangal si Maestro Federico Aguilar Alcuaz, ang kanyang panganay na anak na si Ginoong Christian Aguilar. Mr. Aguilar, welcome to Art2art.
Thank you.
Mr. Aguilar, you are German, if I understand that correctly?
German, but now dual citizen.
Dual citizen. So we will conduct the rest of our interview in English.
Yes, please.
For your comfort and convenience. Okay, on February 2, it would have been a year since your father passed away.
Yes.
And still the national artist controversy is at an impasse.
Yes.
What are your family's feelings about this? And are you, you know, trying to, you know, are you working for a resolution?
Immediately after the death of my father, we were trying to work on a resolution of this problem, but the way it happens is it's a little bit a very difficult approach. You cannot just straightforward do something straightforward because, well, we are in the Philippines. It's a little bit difficult to act things like that.
Mm-hmm.
And also, like, whatever approach we tried or have tried to, everything is depending very much on either the Supreme Court directly or
mm-hmm.
On the president. And both of them have other higher priorities to solve at that time and even up to now. So I personally don't think that it will be resolved like in very, very soon time. I think it will be take a little bit longer, as disappointing as it might be, but then we just have to be patient and wait throughout the whole city for something to be done about it.
Okay, I see, but the way I understand it is this year is also the year for nominating new national artists.
As far as I know, yes, and as far as I am informed, I have been told that the nomination procedure has already been started.
Okay, so it has begun even despite the non-resolution of
yes.
the
I think it just started because per se the whole process has already been filed off and seen as finished as far as the government agents are concerned. For them it's finished, but it's just like it could not have been properly finished in the usual way by giving the awardees or the nominees their merits. That's only. But let's say like formally, everything has already been closed since we have already received the formal confirmation from the president's office
mm-hmm.
that the nominees have been awarded national artists. So
mm-hmm.
formally, it's there, but informally, the whole procedure is not yet complete since the ceremony has not taken place.
Okay. Let's not focus on that for this
yes.
interview. Why don't we focus on your father? How was it like to be the son of, you know, growing up, to be the son of Federico Aguilar Alcuaz?
Let me first say... For us children, it was like rather normal. Although, let's say, like if you look at it from an outside view, our family was everything but normal.
Mm-hmm.
Because for the longest time, my father was not really. Granting us like a real family life. Means he was not there because of his many travels
mm-hmm.
That he had to do.
Mm-hmm.
And then in the end, we ended up like being, how do you say that, location-wise separated. Means
yeah.
My mother moved with the children back to Germany, and
mm-hmm.
my father stayed here or roamed around in order to do his what he had had to or wanted to do.
Mm-hmm.
And but then anyway, this was there was I've heard from my mom, and my father sort of verified it also, that my parents just made this agreement among themselves that it's the best to let my father go so that he can really freely develop his own talents and skills. Mm-hmm. And he would just, whenever he could and it was possible for him, either drop by or support us in however way he can or feels like it, mm-hmm. which he did. But then it's not like he would come up with like a monthly payment or show up every regular on that regular basis. Mm-hmm. It could have happened that we didn't see our father like for as long as like 2 years, mm-hmm. and then just got a note by letter about things like mm-hmm. what happened. Mm-hmm. So in that way, we are a little bit unusual.
Yeah. Okay.
But else of that, for us children, we did not really mind that too much because everything was whatever problem there might have been between my mom and my father, mm-hmm. We were always secluded from it, and then nobody there are no bad feelings among one or the other parents.
I see. What was your earliest memory of your father?
The earliest active memory is actually from the times we were staying here in the Philippines. So mm-hmm. starting about 65, 66.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. And was this also the first time that you realized that your father was a very important artist?
No, we realized pretty soon my brothers and me that our father was somewhat special, mm-hmm. but for us it was never of importance that he was like an important artist. We always knew our father well. He's an artist, and that's mm-hmm. it.
Okay.
So for us it was not really that much an issue.
I see. Well, actually, unknown to many, Alcuaz is the maiden name of your father's mother.
Yes.
Would you know why your father decided to sign his works as Aguilar Alcuaz?
Yes. It was actually until about 56, 57, my father always signed his works Aguilar, which is his legal name. Mm-hmm. And when he moved to Spain after his high school years, mm-hmm. And college years, he found out that the name Aguilar is very common. Mm-hmm. It's like you have 1 million entries in a phone book, and then there are 1 million Aguilars. Just in your neighborhood.
Okay.
And mm-hmm. A lot of even in Spain, it is a fact that if you like to distinguish, if you have a very common name like Aguilar, mm-hmm. You like to have any kind of distinction. And mm-hmm. one of the things they do is like they put forward either the maiden name of the mother, mm-hmm. which he did. Because my father actually did, since we also have direct Alcuaz relatives. Mm-hmm. He put the original name was Aguilar y Alcuaz.
Okay.
So just to put both families and not to make just a simple reverse of the family names, mm-hmm. and later. Because of ease, it was like the E got skipped, and mm-hmm. he just became known as Aguilar Alcuaz. Mm-hmm. And further on, he was just known as Alcuaz, and everybody Alcuaz. Mistakes that as his family.
Yes, that's right. In fact, I have met your father in many cocktail parties in the past, and the first thing he would do every time we would meet, he would take out his flute and start playing on it.
Yes,
in fact, many people would describe him as eccentric. Would yes. you say that this is so?
Yes, up to a certain, I can verify that is true. Uh-huh. But then my father is a highly complex person. It's not as simple as just like he is this or this or that. Mm-hmm. In one way or the other, he's actually I would describe him more as multiple personal person because he has different aspects. He's also like extremely moody, and depending on what mood you pick him, mm-hmm. well, the reactions can be very, very different. It mm-hmm. can be from this or that way, you know, mm-hmm. and good or bad. Sometimes it's bad, mm-hmm. but that's normal. That's almost with everybody. You have that, no?
Yes, that's true. Marami pa po tayong pag-uusapan tungkol sa premiadong pintor na si Federico Aguilar Alcuaz kasama ang kanyang anak na si Christian Aguilar dito pa rin sa Art to Art. Magbabalik po kami pagkatapos ng ilang paalala.
Programang hatid ay sining at kulturang para sa lahat. Magbabalik ang Art to Art. Schedule ng mga inaabangang konsyerto, update sa mga magagandang panoorin sa mga tanghalan at teatro. Narito na ang Art to Art Calendar.
Narito ang ating Arts Calendar. Iniyahandog ng National Commission for Culture and the Arts ang 2012 Philippine Arts Festival na may temang Tradisyon at Inobasyon. Sa buong buwan ng Pebrero, formal itong magbubukas ngayong araw sa Rizal Park. Tampok sa festival ang mga proyekto ng 7 subcommittees ng NCAA na sumasaklaw sa arkitektura, pelikula, sayaw, panitikan, musika, pagtatanghal at sining biswal. Para sa kompletong detalye, bumisita sa website na ncca.gov.ph o mag-email sa ncca.paio@gmail.com. Sa sining biswal, kasalukuyang ginaganap ang kauna-unahang solo exhibit ni Shireen Martinez Seno na pinamagatang Mystery Terrain. Ito'y makikita sa Republika Art Gallery, 186 E. Rodriguez Jr. Avenue hanggang February 4. Tampok ang mga larawang kinuna ni Seno gamit ang black and white film at isang video piece na tumatalakay sa pagdaranas ng isang lugar o ang experience of place. Para sa karagdagang detalye, bumisita sa website na plantingrice.com. Sa musika, tampok ang flutist na si Tony Maige at French pianist na si Michael Rabaud sa konsyertong Tutti Flutti, An Evening of French Music sa February 2, alas 6:30 ng gabi sa UP Abelardo Hall Auditorium, UP Diliman, Quezon City. Para sa karagdagang detalye, tumawag sa 926-0026. Samantala, magsasagawa ang Philippine Philharmonic Orchestra ng audition sa February 10 mula alauna 1:30 ng hapon hanggang alas 4 ng hapon sa Cultural Center of the Philippines. Ito'y para sa Assistant Concertmaster at Orchestra Member na tumutugtog ng brass trombone. Para sa karagdagang detalye, tumawag kay Noreen Oronce at 832-1125 Local 1608 o mag-email sa ppo.culturalcenter@yahoo.com.
For the first time in Philippine Ballet, the most captivating and unforgettable live performances of the country's most beloved prima ballerina, Lisa Macuja, are now available on premium quality DVDs. The Lisa Macuja Swan Song Series, a limited edition collector series of her final full-length performances of the world's most beloved classics, beginning with Swan Lake and Romeo and Juliet. Timeless keepsakes that will bring the magic of ballet into your homes and into your hearts forever. Featuring Ballet Manila and the one and only ballerina of the people, Lisa Macuja. The Lisa Macuja Swan Song Series, now available on high-grade DVDs. For sales and inquiries, please contact Ballet Manila at 400-0292 or 525-5967 or email them at info@balletmanila.ph.
Usapang sining at kultura para sa lahat. Kasama ang balerina ng bayan, si Lisa Macuja. Art to Art.
Kasama pa rin natin sa pagpaparangal kay Federico Aguilar Alcuaz ang kanyang panganay na anak na si Christian Aguilar. You know, for our listeners and viewers who are not familiar with the works of Federico Aguilar Alcuaz, how would you characterize his art in general?
That's a little bit a difficult question because I'm not really an art historian or somebody who can really talk about it. But let's say like what I very much like about my father's works is that the range or the scope of what he does and mm-hmm. did is very broad. Mm-hmm. He's not like some artists who are known for like whatever, one single thing that they're doing or have done. Mm-hmm. My father had done like so many different things, and so many things have not even been shown. Nobody knows about it. It's very, very difficult. And then like, if I would want to market it, it would be very difficult because nobody knows about all these things. And my father, for a lot of things, never intended to actually use a lot of things, but then he had like small things that he was just doing to waste time a little bit in a decent matter, or when he was giving us children some quality time, we used to do things together. Like we were working with enamels, melting enamels, and then my father developed like a small series of small enamel plates some of
he was not just into paintings. No. He was also into sculpture, of course. He was into sculpture in and you mentioned like making little knickknacks as well.
Yes.
Uh-huh. Would you say that he did not have a signature style?
No. Of course, my father has something like what he's very much known for. Like everybody says, like the Tres Marias is one thing. The tapestries, his landscapes. Mm-hmm. Yes, but then that's actually only a part of the whole scope.
Okay, and he was known, of course, to be a very, very prolific artist.
Yes.
Is there a complete catalog of all his works?
Unfortunately, not. Mm-hmm. What I've been doing together with my brothers and my mom is like we are trying to come up with something like a work log. Mm-hmm. This is not intended to be like a whole catalog. This is mainly actually only put together for the purpose of having we want to have like an overview of what my father did, and also try to figure out how big the actual work scope would be. Mm-hmm. But up to now, it's still something that is ongoing, and I don't see that we will ever end with it within like within the next 2, 3, 4, 5 years. It will be ongoing.
Yeah, because it's that many works.
It's that many, and up to now, I'm even finding like for me completely new works. I have never seen them before, and there were no traces.
What among his works are your personal favorites?
I like some of his abstract trilogues, you know, this set together of some smaller abstracts that he did. Mm-hmm. Although it's a lot of people say it's very, very, very kitschy. I do have a favor also for some of the Tres Marias.
The Tres Marias.
Yeah, because they're actually really nice. Mm-hmm. And first I thought like, well, does it have to be something like so simple as that? But actually, it does not mind that it's a very popular and very, very much likely thing. I think it also benefits the artist if he also produces something that the broad audience likes. Mm-hmm. You know? So it's okay. It's good for me. I like some of his still lives. I do have to say that I don't like everything. Mm-hmm. That would be too much. A lot of things are well beyond my scope, and I have actually a very simple state, and I like, well, simple things.
Mm-hmm. Where can we find his works currently on exhibit?
On exhibit, he does not have too many places where broad places are widely exhibit, but GSIS Museum has a huge collection of his tapestries. Mm-hmm. Some of his portraits are also there. Mm-hmm. Banco Central has a few of his early works from the 60s mainly. Mm-hmm. Otherwise, the broad majority are already with collectors, and then it's just like Every now and then, I try to come up with a nice exhibit, not so much for sale purposes as just to show.
Okay.
And then that will be like from our part over the next years, like the more thing that we are focusing on, because. Mm-hmm. Not that we're running out of works, but then the major focus is not anymore like to sell. Mm-hmm. We are over beyond that point already. Mm-hmm. That we have to make a sale, and even sales exhibit are not in anymore a main focus.
Okay. Okay. Beyond his art, what were his other interests? Did he have any hobbies?
No, my father was actually not really a person who had hobbies. Because, as I see it, my father was pretty much fulfilled with what he was doing for art. Mm-hmm. And then his spare time, he really liked to do something beyond art. Mm-hmm. Let's say he would like to be just together with his friends. Mm-hmm. And then they would discuss usually non-art things. Mm-hmm. But then he was interested in daily life. Mm-hmm. My father, being also a lawyer, he was also interested being on legal or political issues. Mm-hmm. Up to a certain extent. Not mm-hmm. that he was really involved in it, just merely for interest.
I see. Well, for a time, your father was known as one of the most famous residents of a certain Manila hotel.
Yes.
Why did he prefer to live in a hotel rather than in a regular house or home?
The staying in a hotel became a point during the time when we were thinking of going back. My mother was thinking of going back to Germany. Mm-hmm. And so my father had to look for a location. He had he was thinking like, what will I do if my family is not here? You did not want to go to our ancestral house in Quezon City. Mm-hmm. Which is at that time far from where all the action was. It's here in Manila. No? Mm-hmm. And then so he said, okay, they were built in 67. The then Hilton was starting to put up the building in UN Avenue. Mm-hmm. And at that time, that was like the first real high-rise in the city. Mm-hmm. So it's also very prominent. And mm-hmm. What my father very much liked is like the view. I found now that even as early as before the official inauguration of the hotel, my father already did landscapes from the roof.
Uh-huh.
And so, and then like it was still in old style, mm-hmm. but it already shows mm-hmm. some of his favorite topics that he developed over the later years. Mm-hmm. Very interesting, actually.
Okay. Did he leave any unfinished works?
Yes.
Yes.
He left.
So he continued painting even after he had fallen ill?
But then of course not anymore to that extent. He did not before he was like finishing or redoing a lot of things, since my father was never really just idle. If he, mm-hmm. he was always doing something, mm-hmm. and even if he was just doodling around, he left a lot of sketches. Of course, the sketches are not regarded mm-hmm. Artworks per se, but then it's like mm-hmm. Thinking of how to set up things, thinking about layouts, mm-hmm. things like that.
Okay. Well, this year is the 80th birth anniversary of Federico Alcuaz.
Yes.
Are there any plans of the family to celebrate this?
Not as far as I know. Our family is actually pretty humble in doing things like that. Of course, we will do a small session to the cemetery, show our respect. That yes, mm-hmm. but then else of that, something like smashing and public festivity. Mm-hmm. That I don't think we will do.
I
that.
See. Okay. Okay. Well, thank you very much for being our guest this afternoon, Christian, and for helping us pay tribute to a great man, a great artist, Federico Aguilar Alcuaz.
Thank you too.
Hanggang sa susunod na linggo, samahan ninyo kami ulit dito sa Art to Art, kung saan ang usapang sining at kultura ay para sa lahat. Ito po ang inyong balerina ng bayan, Lisa Macuja, nagpupugay sa artistang Pilipino.